Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Blind. I am the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. The blood. So much blood. You see a lost spirit. How could he do this to me? Not a rug. The dead body of a young girl. Alright. So yeah, we're at the stone monument. With the Umbra Tribe. Woodland. Oh, there's a knife. Oh. There's firewood. We don't need firewood. I already have some firewood. I can't do anything with it. No one will buy it. I will take these knives, though. I'm assuming they're just standard knives. Yeah. A plant. Oh. I know it's cheating looking around like this, but let's check out the spirit first. Because I ain't afraid of no ghost. Oh, well, look at the monument. There's any description for that. Nothing out of the ordinary. Okay. Rats are gonna come and fight me. Yep. I missed. Somehow. There we go. How could he do this to me? She's still saying. To the right, you see a group of rats feasting on the dead body of a young girl. How horrible. I'm here to kick you into lifelessness. Alright, we're in combat. Get rid of these rats. Betrayed. Betrayed and alone. Where's the other rats? I can't hit it from there, can I? Let's just... I don't want to waste bullets on those, you know what I'm saying? Would you feast on us some more? Eh. I missed both times, okay. Hit it! Oh, good God. Hit one of them. Thank you. Good. I think that takes care of all the rats. Betrayed and alone. Pardon me while I take this Xander root. A simple rug. The weaver was obviously very talented. Okay, I wanted to look at her instead I walked up to her. You see... Oh, well. Though the body has been... partially eaten by rats and other critters, you see evidence of stab wounds. The girl's face is a mask of torment and anguish. Surely her soul is distressed. Okay, I can't talk to the spirit. You see the spirit of a pretty young girl, illuminated by the cold glow of the moon. Okay. I can't interact with the ghost? And I can't pick up the knife, which is okay, because I have so many other knives. As long as it's not a special knife. Maybe I could give her something. I don't know what it could be, though. Alright, I'm not gonna fight the ghost if I don't have to. It's been through enough. Let's check out these guys over here. More firewood. There it comes. That looks like a big one. Alright. 26 hit points. Okay. Guess it's not that big. I'm not gonna pick up another tail. I'm just gonna check to make sure it doesn't have anything else, and I'm gonna save. To save against crashes, really. Nope, nothing else, so. There's another big one over here. 52. Here comes a little one. Ooh, I went up a level. He's gonna come, so let me kill this and then go up a level. I'll level up. Critically hit for 24 hit points. Serious wound was inflicted. 2 points left. Okay. Just tail. Just checking. Alright, so, yeah, leveling up. Pick a perk. Excellent. These are my favorite levels. Adrenaline Rush. Gain +1 to your strength when you drop below a half of your max hit points. Just +1? It doesn't seem that. Bonus move. 2 free APs each turn that can be only used for movement. I would like the shooting one. Cautious nature. You are more alert outdoors, and enemies are less likely to sneak up on you. With this perk, you get a +3 to your perception in random encounters when determining placement. That's cool. That's a new one. Comprehension. 50% more skill points when reading books. Familiar sequence. Know that one. Educated. Each level of educated adds +2 skill points. Yeah. Empathy. You have studied other human beings. You will see the reaction level of the person you are talking to and involved in in-depth conversation. I had that in the first Fallout, and that was pretty handy. Faster healing. +2 bonus to your healing rate. Each level heals 4 to 10 additional hit points when using first aid or doctor skills. Evo. Yeah, plus 2 strength for purposes of determining range with thrown weapons only. Okay, here and now. With this perk, you immediately gain 1 experience level. Huh. Kama Sutra Master. Oh god. Did I see this one before? When it comes to pleasing sexually, you wrote the book. Yeah, it's... I don't know if I'm going to be needing that very much, but we'll find out, I guess. Magnetic Personality. 1 extra slot to your companion limit. But don't forget that more than 5 is always a crowd. More than 5 is always a crowd, okay. Night Vision. Eh, not that useful in the first game. Pack Rat. Carry a little extra in your inventory. Presence. Your initial reaction of another person is improved by 10% for each level. Quick Pockets. Accessing your inventory only costs you 2 action points in combat instead of 4. That's why someone said, I don't know who it was, it said, it takes 2 action points to get into your inventory. Yeah, with that perk. I don't know if that's something someone said to me or I saw somewhere else and I was like, no, it's 4. They probably have the perk and just forgot about it. Quick Recovery. You are quick at recovering from being knocked down. Rad Resistance. Each level improves your rad resistance by 15%. Ranger. Plus 15% towards outdoorsman's skill. More likely to avoid random encounters if you choose. And tend to find special encounters more than most. Hmm. You have improved your ability to see distant locations, increasing the size of exploration on the world map by 1 square in each direction. You also have a better chance of finding special encounters. So we have 2 for special encounters. If you take both, you'll be really certain to get some special encounters. You have learned to increase your dialogue options without understanding what you're talking about. Each level will increase your intelligence by 1 up to 10 for dialogue only. Snake Eater. That's plus 25% to your poison resistance. Stonewall. Less likely to be knocked down in combat. Looks a lot like the Thing from Fantastic Four. Strong Back. You can carry an additional 50 pounds of equipment for each level. Swift Learner. 5% bonus, of course, let's take an early Thief. A one-time bonus of plus 10% to sneak, lockpick, steal, and traps. Bonus move. I'm looking for that perk. Yeah. I'm looking for that perk that helps with extra shot or whatever. I'm not sure exactly. It might be called extra shot or bonus shot. Maybe that shows up later. Empathy, I kind of like that. I had that in the first one and that was handy. You could see the red was, you know, don't click on the red if you don't want to piss people off. Click on the blue and they'll like you more or they'll continue to like you. Empathy. Oh, there's a few others that I really like, but I'm gonna take empathy. If I had that bonus shot or whatever, bonus combat round, or bonus combat AP, then I would definitely take that, but it is not here right now, so let's take empathy. And skill points. Right, we want lock picking up so we can get into that crap. Only 30% right now, so I'm going to put a lot into that. 45% now. I can't get to 50. When I get to 50 or more, or I find dynamite or some other kind of explosive, even a grenade, if I can use that out of combat, I will, do that. I will go back to Klamath, but for now, yeah, 45%, and I'll put the rest right now into small guns. wanted to wait to see if I can get another book, but I don't know where I don't know when that will happen, so. Done. And since we did all that work, let's just save again. This game is far from stable at times, so. Keep the fire burning. Fish. I got fish. Firewood. A brock flower. Two brock flowers. Is that the kind we can use with the Xander root? These pots are empty. Bones. We can search the bones. Look at that. We have five things and a sharpened spear. Cool. I keep wanting to call them bottle caps. So, fish. Yeah. A raw-looking fish. If cooked, it would probably make a tasty meal. It weighs 5 pounds. Okay. Can we cook it? Does nothing. Well, you told me it would be make a tasty meal, and you keep it from me. Okay. More firewood, I trust? Yep. More scorpions. Missed. Come on over here. Stop missing, that'd be great. Oh, big one's coming now. I don't think he'll be able to reach me for purposes of hitting me this round. Yeah. Cool. I got the nice 95% now. Yeah, we don't actually have that much. I'll be switching weapons if we run out of that, which is 35 left. Yeah, the powder for the powder of healing. Okay. So if I wanted to, I could return and have the shaman make me some more. I have two of these and. Wherever the Xander root is. Okay, so here's the other gun. I'd switch to the 10mm. And that. That's 10mm, yeah. So yeah, Xander root, I have three. So I can make two healing powders if I wanted to. Oh, there's another one. Yay. So we are, what? We're level 6 already. We're gonna... Virgin of the Wastes. Karma's 156. I'm inexperienced. Okay, here's another, flower. So now I can get 3 of those roots. If I can get out of my own way. I don't know what to do with that spirit. I'm thinking maybe give her something, but I don't know what that could be. I'd like to actually help the spirit, believe it or not. Alright, so we got Umbra Tribe. Don't know if this is their land, if I should put the gun away, but since I don't know, I'll leave it out. Okay, the tribe is up here, apparently. A pole with human skulls attached. Alright, let's put the gun away. Might be foolish to do so, but I come in peace. And with my strong punch. You enter the Umbra Shore, home of the Umbra Tribe. You see many differences in appearance on the villagers' tents, as if not all come from the same place. A tribal. Blood with bones. Nothing out of the ordinary. Talented weavers they have, at least. I'm not going to take anything out of it. At least not yet. This empty stake looks ready for an unwilling victim. Maybe I'm... Let's not set foot in the thing, just in case we're not supposed to. Go away, Outworlder. Be gone. I'm seeking counsel with the spirits, and they don't like you, Outworlder. If you must speak to me, do it another time. No need to be so rude. Bye. A bucket. Well, I don't want to anger them by taking anything or messing with their well. Sad to say. Why do you plague us? Well, they don't like me, but at least they're not attacking me. Yet. Look, there's more fish. Yummy fish. A strong-looking tribal. Hail, friend. You be needing something? This isn't going to go over well. I have the empathy thing, though. So this is not red, so it shouldn't provoke an attack. Yeah, I was wondering who you're guarding. I'd be guarding tribe's holy leader, he who walks with spirits. Much honor guarding him. Keep out unwanted, like you. Now leave. Mm-hmm. An ancient-looking tribal. I don't know if I should just try to... I gotta speak with the elder, though, right? The warrior. This sun-bronze giant looks as if his corded muscles were carved out of granite. Beneath a mane of black hair, his smoldering blue eyes... What? Oh. I thought I said room. His smoldering blue eyes roam unabashedly over your body. Nice. I'm Krom, the head leader of this tribe. By the gods, girl, your beauty could drive a man mad. Okay. Where do you get these pickup lines, Krom? Uh. I don't want to sleep with him. But maybe I can use my feminine wiles to get what I want. Smile. Thank you, Crom. He grins wolfishly. Despite his scarred and rough appearance, he possesses a rugged handsomeness. Tell me, girl, what's your name, and what brings you to our village? I'm Andrea King, and I'm on a holy quest to save my village, Arroyo, from certain destruction. Arroyo, yes, one of the northern tribes. But what of this certain destruction you speak of? Your village is well fortified by a large canyon, is it not? Surely you can defend against enemy tribes or invaders. It is not an outside force that threatens us. My tribe is dying from within. We've suffered a terrible drought, and it seems my village is doomed to wither and die, unless I can find the holy Gek in time. Ah, a Garden of Eden creation kit. I've read of them in the old texts. He smiles grimly. It's unfortunate that your tribe has fallen on hard times, but it's foolish to place all your hope on finding some magical artifact from before the Great Silence. Are you sure your tribe didn't send you on a fool's errand simply to be rid of you? Okay, so now I know, because of that perk, that I should not choose that one. Unless I want to offend him. Of course, Knight. I successfully conquered the Temple of Trials and earned the highly respected title of the Chosen One. That's why I've been given this quest, because I've proved myself to be the most qualified. Now, what have you read of the Gek? Why exactly did we come here? I don't know. We went a long way. I hope they can help me with something or we get something out of this. Besides a few fish. He dismissively shrugs his mighty shoulders. Just another of the old one's lazy scientific baubles, meant to replace the tried and true method of man tailing against the unforgiving earth. Toiling, sorry. Forging his own existence through sweat and blood. But if you truly believe such a device is your only hope, then I suggest you seek out the old one's underground vaults. I've traveled far and wide, but I've never found one myself. But then, I wasn't exactly looking. Okay. Easily offended, I guess. My village elder is certain that finding the Gek is the best chance we've got. That's what I've been tasked with, so that's what I intend to do. Anyway, thanks for the tip. You're a stubborn one. By the gods, I think I could get to like you, girl. He grins and slaps you on the rear with a hand that seems capable of crushing boulders. Well, I guess it's good he didn't crush my ass. While you're here, perhaps you could assist us with a thing or two. What do you say? Well, if you can't keep your hands to yourself, then I just might consider helping. That will piss him off. Sorry, but I just don't have the time. In fact, we're surely moving along now. No one touches me, asshole. Attack, of course, that's going to be bad. That all depends. Huh. Interesting, this is a bad choice. What have you got in mind, big guy? Well, either I'm too easy for him, or he's going to be seeing through my bluff, I guess. Because that's what it would be. Sure, I suppose I can help out a bit before I go. What would you like me to do? You wouldn't want me to help you with that ghost to the south, would you? He looks you over, seeming to consider something for a moment. I'm to meet with one of them damn civilized traders soon. A pudgy, one-eyed dog of a man, who I trust about as much as a starving rad scorpion. He's not wronged us yet, but I've got a feeling about our next meeting. Why's that? When last we spoke, he boasted he'd been bringing me something truly miraculous, and that I'd be wise to haul all the golden gecko hides I could carry to the meet. I don't know what his miracle item is, but it's likely some civilized trinket that he'll hope I'll be ignorant of enough to pay for more than it's worth. That's why I'd like you to make the trade. So now he won't be offended if we turn him down. Why me? Because you're my kin. Fellow tribal, as they call us. Yet I can tell you've had recent experience with the civilized world. If he tries to pull something, you'd be more likely to spot it than me. Besides, I got a good feeling about you, girl, and I've learned to trust my instincts. If I help you, what's in it for me? I offer the hospitality of our tribe and the opportunity to impress me. I promise no more than that. Alright, but give me a moment to get ready. Yeah, because I'm going to save the game. Are you ready to go? Alright, let's do this. Oh, I should have put my weapon in. Hopefully this will be a more of a diplomatic thing anyway. As you and Crom approach the meeting site, you're greeted by a chubby merchant with an eye patch and a small entourage of bodyguards. Though the merchant is sweating profusely, he appears downright cheerful. After the merchant gives Crom an enthusiastic greeting, he turns to you and looks you over. Though his grin never falters, his probing eye betrays a hint of suspicion. So Crom here says I'm to do business with you today. He shrugs. Folks call me One-Eyed Roy, but I can't for the life of me figure out why. He laughs heartily at his joke. What's your name, friend? Is he one-eyed? I see no reason to give away Arroyo. Andrea King. Now let's get this underway. His grin falters slightly and he nods. All right, down to business then. Tell me, friend, have you ever heard of a little item called a stimpak? As he dramatically speaks the last word, he produces a stimpak from his coat pocket and holds it up like a wondrous artifact. Have I heard of a stimpak? Yeah. Actually, they're pretty common. He chuckles nervously. I wouldn't say they're common, but they're certainly coveted by our civilized folks. He looks at Crom, and for good reason. You see, these little guys contain magical healing powers that will astound and amaze you. Of course, words mean nothing without proof, so allow me to show you the wonders of the Stimpak in action. I already know how they work. I've used them myself plenty of times. Ignoring your comment, he grins at Crom, then turns to one of his bodyguards. Warren, come give me your hand. Can we tell? Is Warren already injured? The guard frowns but does as he's told. Roy quickly takes out a knife, and slashes it across the top of Warren's arm. Warren winces with pain but does not cry out. As you can see, Warren's got quite a nasty gash here. I assure you, friends, the cut and Warren's pain are quite genuine. You can see this is no trick blade. He hands the knife to Crom, who hardly glances at it before nodding and handing it back. But now look! He injects the stimpak into Warren's arm. Almost instantly, the bleeding stops. Roy uses a dirty rag to mop away most of the blood, revealing a gash that's nearly healed. Now just imagine the advantage having stimpaks would give you over your rival tribes. And unlike that healing powder you fellows like to brew up, the stimpak does not cause drowsiness. In fact, this little wonder is completely without side effects. But I know what you're thinking. They might cost a fortune, right? Wrong. Because I like you. I'm practically giving them away for nothing. Practically giving them away? How much are you asking? I'll give you this entire crate full of them. That's 50 stimpaks. And all I ask in return is a measly 20 golden gecko pelts. You just can't beat a deal like that. That is a good deal. That's a good deal, all right. Too good. What's the catch? No catch, my friend. I simply already have all the stimpaks I need, so I'm offloading my excess supply. Golden pelts, on the other hand, I can never have enough of those. Sure, 50 stimpaks are worth far more than a mere 20 golden gecko pelts, but I'm being realistic. I can't expect your tribe, skilled hunters though I'm sure you are, to have 100 golden gecko hides lying around, so I'm making a more reasonable offer. That's why it's such a good deal. Yeah, I don't trust this. Before you agree to anything, I'd like to have a look at the rest of the goods. His eye narrows slightly, then he grins. Of course. They're in this crate next to me. Huh. Okay. Crate next to him. That crate? Antsy bodyguard. Disgruntled bodyguard. These guys are not feeling very happy right now. A caravan wagon converted from the wrecked remains of an ancient automobile. Automobile? Still getting everything else first. Moo. Next time we should just cut one of the tribals. When do I get to shoot something? Let's get this shit on the road. I'm hungry. Alright, let's... It's up to you to decide, Crom says. Let's look in the crate. After giving the crate a brief look over, you determine that there's about 50 stim packs in it, just like the merchant said. Well, I have the option to examine them further. Why wouldn't I? Upon closer inspection, these stim packs look a bit odd to you. You take one and squirt a little of its fluid onto your palm. Upon sniffing the crimson liquid, you realize what it truly is. Brahmin blood. Nice. Alright. Alright, if you're done messing around, let's get this show on the road. I'm a busy man. Those stim packs are fake. They're nothing but hypodermics filled with Brahmin blood. You were trying to rip this tribe off. What? That's impossible. You saw the demonstration. They work fine. I'm not going to stand here and let you try and ruin my good name. Okay. Sure, the stim pack you used during the demonstration was real, but I'd like to see you try it again using one of the stim packs in that crate. He sneers. All right, fine. If you say they're fake, then maybe they are. How should I know? I didn't make the things. I bought them. So I'm the one that was ripped off here, not you. Now, since there's no deal, I'm not going to waste my time here any longer. Bye. Should I attack?